Last outing with Bring Me the Horizon, we got to experience the first of their now preferred EP format for releasing music. Supposedly being done with albums, Music to Listen to suggested an experimental, carefree direction for the group. At 32 minutes, Survival Horror feels like an album, but it is just the first of four releases under the Post-Human banner. Formats and definitions aside, this is undoubtedly a great listening experience that explains itself regardless of how it's packaged up and sold. There is also the price, can't complain about saving a few quid to pick it up. With these 9 tracks, Bring Me the Horizon step back to the cutting edge. Their fusion of electronic metal and pop thrives within the throttling production that gives all instruments a punchy clarity while retaining the wall of sound energy. Most of these songs land between Ammo and That's the Spirit, poppy hooks and structures with splashes of electronica just about everywhere. It kicks off with a notable dip into exhilaration as the blast beats and lively guitar work show some strong extreme metal influences. A fascinating collaboration with Baby Metal stands out. Kingslayer is a song that could have easily fit on the Japanese group's record as it utilizes their song style and aesthetic quirks. The rest of the record mostly toys with different temperaments of pop metal, the loud, quiet dynamic, and many creative ways of delivering catchy earworms. It's still fondly reminiscent of the Hybrid Theory formula, the song Teardrop practically a tribute to that record with its parallel guitar tone and ideal song structure. The band constantly sway between tuneful swoons and doses of heavy, often punctuated with dense synthesizers droning in syncopation with the guitars. The percussion too has an entanglement with drum machines and drum and bass samples that give the songs a textural weight to bolster the music with aesthetic intrigue. It's made revisiting these songs fun as the depth has one picking apart at the layers that make it up. On the lyrical front, its opening songs seem poised to reflect on the internal stresses and turmoil the current pandemic is putting many people through right now. It's a middle-of-the-road, unpolitical take that wrangles out frustrations caused by the situation. It could just be coincidence from a band that frequently deals with the negative spectrum of emotions through their words. It's all just a little uncanny, though. Survival Horror is a sharp record, concise, creative, and at the edge of cunning. The group have managed to again evolve their sound in exciting directions. For a handful of guests who bring on extra voiceage and no shortage of ideas, it ends up being a fruitful affair with something for everyone. It's been stated that each of the four parts will have their own identity. I'd love more in this vein, but the idea of pushing something different with each release has me excited for their future. This band have long defied the odds against their origin, and watching them continue on is simply fantastic. Thanks for listening. If you'd like to see some more of my music blogs, go check the website out. Every page is over 1,000 articles sorted by artist, year, genre, and more. Just hit Control F and have a search for something that interests you. You can find a link to the blog in the description box down below, where you'll also find links to my other YouTube channels. Check them out if you are curious. Thanks again for watching, and be sure to subscribe to catch the next upload.